Revelation 2022 live in Toronto. Please welcome to the stage your master of ceremonies for the evening, Azalea Hart.
My microphone. Okay, there we go. Good evening, everyone. I am Azalea Hart, and I would like to welcome you all to the historic Evergreen Brickworks for a celebration of the finest cuisine in Toronto. I am so glad to be here to share this historical moment with you all. We are soon going to discover the first ever Michelin Guide selection right here in Toronto. We're gonna honor these amazing restaurants, their chefs, and teams. Michelin has been wowed by Toronto's extraordinary culinary landscape, as well as the fantastic work done by Destination Toronto, Destination Ontario, and Destination Canada. We're all very excited to hear who earns Michelin distinctions tonight, as well as enjoy the amazing food from Adrak Yorkville and Pie. Are you enjoying the food so far? I would say so. Michelin would also like to give a huge special thank you to our presenting partner, Capital One. Thanks also to go to our official partners, Air Canada, Blancpain, DoorDash, V. Glenlivet. Additionally, Michelin would like to recognize preferred partners for Jean Frères, Candle Artistique, those amazing smelling candles that you see on the tables, Petrosian, Porsche, and the George Brown Culinary Institute. They're over there, if you didn't know. Now it is my pleasure to introduce the International Director of the Michelin Guides, Gwendol Polinak. Hi, Gwendol. Welcome, welcome.
Thank you.
What a night for Toronto.
Yeah, how are you tonight?
I am good, I'm fantastic. The first Michelin Guide selection in Canada.
Yes, it is an historic moment for both the Michelin Guide and Toronto. And first of all, Michelin would like to acknowledge the indigenous peoples as the original caretakers of these lands and waterways. Tikaronto is the gathering place of many nations and peoples, past and present, recorded and unrecorded, and is what is known as the dish with one spoon territory. The culinary community has a close relationship with the land and understands how it must be shared for the mutual benefit of all. When on these lands, we all eat out of the dish and share this territory with only one spoon. So tonight, we acknowledge, celebrate, and respect the varied foodways and cultural traditions of the indigenous communities.
Yes, it is such a privilege to be here tonight in this city, in this amazing venue. We are in for a special treat and a lot of them. Now I would like to welcome Scott Beck, Destination Toronto President and CEO.
Wow, just wow. Thank you, Gwendol and Azalea. Gwendol, merci pour tout votre soutien et vos conseils tout au long de ce voyage. I'd like to thank everyone for joining us this evening. Nous sommes très heureux que vous soyez ici avec nous ce soir pour célébrer ce moment incroyable. We've all been looking forward to learning which restaurants would be part of the Michelin Guide Toronto. Since the announcement past May, can't believe it's been that quick. And now the night is here. Before we move on to the selections, I'd like to say a few more thank yous. First and foremost, I want to express gratitude to Toronto's rich and diverse culinary community. It takes a village to make moments like this happen. Your talent, your passion, your collaboration, innovation, and your resilience is why we are here tonight. We're very excited that your hard work, commitment to your passion, has brought this global spotlight onto your scene. Yes, it takes great chefs and talented culinary professionals, but it also takes great suppliers, producers, and the products that bring the recipes and creations to life. It takes a great service staff, a front of the house staff, to make patrons feel welcome and the food come to life. We recently lost a very passionate member of our village. Sandy de Almeida embodied the passion and commitment to her craft that is being celebrated here tonight. Sandy epitomized the energy and the creativity that makes great culinary experiences possible. And we all know that there are very few things that make food taste better than something yummy to drink. We also are lucky to have our talented culinary, we're also lucky to have our future culinary talent here with us tonight. The students and faculty at George Brown College are helping us service tonight's event. Thank you very much, students. As I noted, it takes a village to make nights like tonight possible. I want to thank our partners at Destination Ontario and Destination Canada, without whom none of this would be possible. I also want to recognize that this opportunity would not have been possible without the early passion of William Chang and Franco Stalteri. We have a lot of gratitude to their passion for Toronto's culinary community. It is now my distinct pleasure to welcome Toronto's Chief Sales Officer, a tireless champion for Toronto, whose passion and advocacy was on display throughout the entire pandemic. Please help me welcome Mayor John Tory to the stage.
Thank you, and ladies and gentlemen, it's such a thrill to be here. I'll just mention in a moment sort of where I think the early derivation of this came from, but before that I want to say to Scott, for a guy from Utah, that French was really good. Better than mine will be when I speak a few words of French in a moment. But and I want to say, by the way, as well, how pleased I am to be here with Neil Lumsden. Neil is the new minister. They changed the titles around, but sport, culture, recreation, and I'll add food in there. And some of you will know he was a great Canadian athlete, but he's also just a wonderful guy. And it's about partnerships, the partnership between the City of Toronto, the Government of Canada, the Government of Ontario, and the industry that has made possible what we're celebrating here tonight. And Neil's going to be a big part of that going forward. But what I was going to tell you, the story I was going to tell you is I swear, and people know on my team that it's a true story, within 1 month of becoming mayor back in 2015, I asked the question, why doesn't Toronto have a Michelin guide? And William and Franco and others, we had a meeting, and they sort of explained to me how it worked, and the work began. And if it wasn't for the hard work that they have done together with Destination Ontario and Destination Canada and the industry, we wouldn't be here tonight. But I happen to believe tonight is a very, very important night for this city. You know, I mean, we make a lot of lists, and we deserve to make those lists. It's no reason for complacency, but we're among the most livable cities, the most diverse cities, the most safe cities in the world. But there had been nothing that really had celebrated in the way that I think this will, the Michelin Guide, our food and culinary scene, and our entire hospitality scene, because, of course, Michelin Guides are about even more than food and about restaurants. And I think, because it also illustrates, you know, somebody asked me outside, one of the media people, what is it about our culinary scene? And I said, well, it's diverse and dynamic, but it's authentic. And I think that people will get a message from that end of how we live here, the food and culinary scene, about this city. And I think it will not only boost that industry, which is so important to us, and create so many jobs and bring such joy to so many people, but it will also, I think, be one more way we put ourselves on the map for people from around the world to want to come here, and not just to visit and not just to eat, but to live here and to invest here and to understand that our food and culinary scene, together with arts and culture and many other things, are an important part of our way of life here. And so when people have a little bit to me kind of said, well, maybe this isn't such a big deal, it's a big deal. It's a big deal because it is going to put Toronto one more time, in one more way, on the map, just like TIFF does. And I think that's important for the well-being of the industry that suffered so much during the pandemic, but I think it's also important for the well-being and the growth and the success and the reputation of this city. So I will just say one more time, congratulations to all those who made this happen, to all those who got behind it and supported it. But you know, the most important people to congratulate are the restaurateurs, those who will be in the guide and those who won't. because together, if you think back to the days of, and this is no disrespect to the Mervish family who I love, but back to the days of a slice of roast beef, mashed potato and peas, and that was kind of what you did before you went to the theater, we've come a long way and we've got a long way to go. And this is gonna help us on that path to being the city that I know we are, which I believe is the greatest city in the greatest country in the world. Thank you. Oh, I didn't speak, hang on. I gotta at least compete with Scott. Merci très sincèrement à Michelin d'avoir fait confiance à Toronto. Nous ne vous laisserons pas tomber. We're not going to let you down. We're going to do a great job for you. Thank you very much.
Bien fait, mon ami. Bien fait. I would dare say that there's not many people that are as excited as the mayor is. I know there's some chefs and restaurateurs, but I think the mayor is more excited for announcements than anybody. Our next speaker is new to his role, but not to Ontario. Many of us in this room have already seen how passionate he is about the impact of his ministry and the extraordinary power culinary experiences play in showcasing Ontario to the world. A role that will clearly have a big impact on travel and business events, both of which are vital to the rebuilding of our visitor economy of Toronto. We're extremely grateful for his support here today. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome the newly appointed Minister of Tourism, Culture and Sport, the Honourable Neil Lumsden.
And the winners are... What do you laugh? Oh, never mind. What a fabulous evening. And I'd like to say it's great to see you all, but I can't see a thing with my glasses on except what I'm looking at. But what I can see is, and very proud to say on behalf of Premier Ford and the Government of Ontario, thank you for joining us for this exciting announcement and fabulous evening. We know how important the strong tourism sector is to our economy and our communities, both large and small. That's why we continue to support Ontario's tourism industry and its operators. You know, our province has so much to offer, from vibrant cities to historic small towns to big towns like Toronto, run by a guy like John Tory, who I think has been a great example of leadership in the tough times, which makes leadership in the easier times even better for us. You've done a tremendous job, and I'd like everyone to show their appreciation. Mayor Tory. And it's not a perfect segue to go from the mayor, but then there's the food. The diverse and quality cuisines made here already in this city and across North America is unbelievable. But this is where we want them to come. This is the place, Toronto. You know, it's a recognition like this. I want to do a little bit of homework, and I understand how important an evening like this is to so many different people. And I oftentimes find myself stepping back and gathering my thoughts when I see how passionate people are, how important things are to people, and how they are willing to show their passion and celebrate high quality at all levels, whether it's this venue, whether it's the food that's being served this evening, or the awards that are going to be handed out. I mean, this is a big frickin' deal, if anyone hasn't noticed, and I'm thrilled to be part of it. You can't imagine how excited I am. When people come to Toronto, they already do think they could be in New York, they could be in Paris. We have the same things here in this city. In our backyard, we have a wealth of opportunity and quality products, restaurants, food, tourism, sports, and the one thing that makes everything go, and people. And I didn't grow up too far from here, and I knew this area pretty well, but I didn't know this was going on, and it really shows me an example of how far we've come. Now, I know you said, okay, when I was a kid, that wasn't that long ago for anyone who's a smartass out there. I won't take up any more time because this is not about us this evening. This is about something that's very special. But I thought just off after reading a couple articles, I wonder if the Michelin brothers, when they created a guide in 1900 that would had, you know, some directions, a map, some techniques to help them if their car breaks down, to 20 years later to including in that guide ratings of restaurants. Go figure, this is where we are today. They're a couple of smart guys on a lot of different reasons, and that's why we're here this evening. Congratulations to everyone, and thank you for including me in your invite. Have a great night.
Tonight. We are definitely just getting started. How are you feeling tonight?
Very well. I really feel great. And merci beaucoup, Monsieur le Ministre et Monsieur le Maire, pour vos mots qui nous touchent beaucoup et votre support. So thank you again for your support. And I talk on behalf of the inspector team when I say how proud we are tonight to reveal this very first election to Toronto.
Well, I speak for everyone in the crowd when I say that we are ready to find out who is who. So you mentioned the Michelin inspectors. Tell us a little bit about them and their process.
Yes, you know, our international inspectors are people from more than 15 different nationalities. They are passionate professionals. They share all a love for great cooking, for great food, and they are spending their time researching and analyzing the restaurants. In the field, our inspectors behave just like any other regular guest. They pay their bill in full, and the same inspectors never go twice to the same place. And all the decisions are team decisions to ensure that ultimately our recommendations have the same value everywhere in the world.
Okay, got it. Eating for a living. I feel like I know a little bit something about that. When you tell us about what they found in Toronto, just to whet our appetites, let us know.
Yeah, you know, well, our inspectors found a good representation of Toronto's strongest talents. These are not just global outposts either. There is a lot of local talent, and some of the restaurants have been here for many years already. And I'm pleased to reveal that this very first selection includes 74 total restaurants and features 27 types of different cuisine.
Wow.
And so we are celebrating the first selection in a new destination. The guide is more than 120 years old. And for that entire time, it has been an independent publication produced by Michelin Group employees.
So the inspectors, they're anonymous. So what's the criteria that they follow?
Yeah, the famously anonymous inspectors have been rating the restaurants following always 5 universal criteria: the quality of the product, the mastery of cooking techniques, harmony and balance of flavor, I mean the taste, the personality of the chef and team as expressed on the plate, and last but not least, you know, the consistency both over time and throughout the menu as a whole. And with this methodology, we ensure that all recommendations have the same value in Tokyo, Paris, or Toronto.
Wow, so Michelin is the pioneer in rating the culinary excellence. And it's interesting how the Michelin Guide has evolved through time. I know that you've launched a mobile app, and it's available for free, by the way, and that's where all of the selections will be online right after the ceremony, so you guys could download that. But before revealing the selections, we'd like to start with some special Michelin awards. Gwendol, could you tell us more about these?
Yes, you know, as you may know, all culinary distinctions go to a restaurant as a whole to reward high-quality teamwork. But with this special award, the Michelin Guide wants to recognize the diversity of jobs in the restaurant industry. while also honoring the individual who make a dining experience unforgettable. So these outstanding professionals are identified by the Michelin Guide inspection team. So often, one of the most, you know, memorable aspects of the fine dining restaurants is the staff attention to detail and ability to anticipate guest needs. And that's why we have created the Michelin Service Award.
Yeah, so this is definitely a choice made by the inspectors. And here to present the award, we'd like to welcome Timothy Liu of Air Canada.
Thank you. Air Canada is a proud partner of the Michelin Guide at this very momentous occasion to recognize and celebrate Toronto's diverse dining experiences and rich culinary culture. We are proud to call Toronto our global hub. And from Toronto, Air Canada's flight network connects the city and the region with people and culture from all across the world. At Air Canada, we have made elevating the customer experience a top priority and to deliver best-in-class service. With this in mind, we are excited to partner with the Michelin Guide in presenting the Michelin Service Award. The Michelin Guide inspectors recognize professionals in the restaurant business that stands out by his or her ability to make all customers comfortable, making the restaurant visit a true experience by guiding and advising guests. I am proud to present the Michelin Service Award to the team at Adulis, led by chefs Michael Caballo and Toby Nemeth. Putting the customer first in all that we do is a value that Air Canada shares. With the vision of creating a memorable experience for customers, we congratulate the team at Adulis and look forward to welcoming you all on an Air Canada flight soon. Caballo and Nemeth, please come up to the stage if you're here.
Restaurants to hand them the award directly.
Exactly.
There we go. Okay, well, up next, we have Sommelier of the Year. So while enjoying good food, we often like to pair it with an amazing wine. So a good sommelier is a guide on this taste journey.
And I'm proud to present the Sommelier of the Year Award to... Christopher Silly! Thank you. Ah, you took the shortcut. You already have the bottle.
Désolé, mais 7 o'clock. I did not know this was happening.
But you arrived perfect, right on time.
Yes. Thank you.
So. And with your skills, you are definitely, you know, enhancing the whole dining experience.
Oh, well. Yeah. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you. Cocktails Award. Michelin strives to recognize all aspects of the culinary experience, including honoring those who create unique, top-quality cocktails.
And the award goes to... the bar team at the Osteria Giulia.
Thank you very much. This goes to the entire team at Osteria Giulia, all of our wonderful bartenders and managers there that have put all of their effort in from day one. The award is for them, not for us. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you, and to quote the inspector, they have been amazed by your talent and creativity in balancing flavors to create a unique and unforgettable cocktail. So congratulations to both of you.
What a way to start. Congratulations, everyone, so far. I think it's time, though, to discover Toronto's elite restaurants. But before we start, can you tell us, Wendell, what being in the Michelin Guide selection means?
A Michelin Guide, to be part of the Michelin Guide selection means that you have been recognized for the quality of your food, regardless of the style of your cooking. From luxury high-end restaurants to casual local eateries, it is all about what is on the plate. And these restaurants are considered as the best in the destination. So being part of a selection is a great accomplishment.
Okay, got it. But the Michelin Guide is particularly known for its stars. But there are other distinctions, such as the Bib Gourmand, right?
Yes, indeed. The Bib Gourmand distinction highlights restaurants offering exceptional good food at moderate prices.
Got it. So let's get started with the Bib Gourmand, shall we? Restaurant teams, when you hear your name, please come on up to the stage.
And the first Bib Gourmand in Toronto are the Ace, Alma, Bar Raval, Campechano, Cherry Street Barbecue. Please come on stage. We are more to come.
Still waiting for everyone else.
Thank you.
seconds to keep it rolling. Chica's Chicken. Enoteca Social. Fat Pasha.
Stay with us.
Favorites Thai. Fonda Balam. And Grey Garden.
Let's continue because we have other addition for the Bib Gourmand category with India Street Food Company, La Bartola, Puerto Bravo, R&D, Similicious Smoked Meat and Deli, and Vinona.
Congratulations to our Bib Gourmand recipients. Let's keep the round of applause going. We'll get everyone in for a photo. As tight as you can go.
So tonight, all together, we have 17 restaurants being awarded with the Bib Gourmand.
We can keep the round of applause going, I think. Amazing. Thank you all so much. Now, for the moment that we have been waiting for, it is time for the big reveal. The first Michelin-starred restaurant in Toronto. Gwendol, the Michelin star is iconic for gourmets and paramount achievement for restaurant professionals.
Now, definitely, you know, all star highlights the gastronomic excellency of a destination. Being a star restaurant means that you are not only among the best restaurants in your city, but in your country and in the world.
So when your name is called, please come up to receive your star and remain on stage.
And we are pleased to welcome to the 2022 selection of the Michelin Guide in Toronto with one star to... Amuri Hanna. Addition to the one-star family. Let's discover it together. Restaurant. Aldo.
Chris.
Ready? Adobo, Yorkville, you again.
Chef Patrick Prince and Rebecca Bruce.
Patrick and Rebecca. Not yet, so we move to the next addition. Restaurant. Enigma Yorkville.
Chef Quentin Bennett, everyone.
Continue, restaurant.
Hashimoto.
8 one-star, but we have more to come. Restaurant. Osteria Giulia. One-star family tonight. Yukashi. Toronto.
And of course, we would like to recognize all who are with us here tonight and extend sincere congratulations to those who couldn't be. Let's give another round of applause. Okay, well, I'm hungry, so... Time to eat?
Not quite yet.
All right, well, what else do we have coming up, Gwendol?
So not quite yet, because we have two Michelin stars to award to restaurants that amazed our inspectors. One star is already an accomplishment, but two star is definitely another level of culinary experience. Please, chef, join me on stage to welcome Restaurant Sushi Masaki Saito.
Very, very happy and exciting.
Is there anyone you want to shout out?
Yeah, can I tell something?
Sure.
Yeah. So thank you, Michelin, for coming to Toronto. And nice to meet you, everyone. My name is Justin Bieber. Laughing, please. So I'm too drunk. Okay. Sorry, I forgot what should I say? Something. So I want to tell that just two. One is I love Toronto, I love Canada. Thank you. One more thing is I'm still single. I don't know why. That's all. Thank you so much.
Congratulations. All right, let's get everyone up for a group photo. Everyone can grab some champagne. We're just gonna do a toast and a photo.
Congratulations to the 74 restaurants in this first selection, so including 17 Bib Gourmand, 12 one-star, 1 two-star restaurants. So this inaugural selection represents Toronto's diversity and talent. Food lovers from the world have a lot to discover in this amazing city, and I think I deserve a glass of champagne as well.
Yeah. We didn't get any. But thank you again, Gwendol. A huge congratulations to all the chefs, restaurateurs, and teams. We just made history, that's right. We have been celebrating tonight. Don't forget, thank you, that the whole Toronto selection is available on the Michelin Guide app, and it's free.
So bravo à tous, you are making history. So cheers à votre santé.
Cheers. Cheers.